How to identify the three pins of a transistor correctly. An electric circuit is made up of a combination of different electrical components. One of these electrical components is the transistor. A transistor is an essential part of an electric circuit. Its function is to convert a weak signal from a low-resistance circuit to a high-resistance circuit. An example of the most common problems that professionals face while designing a circuit is identifying pin connections in many devices. These devices include transistors, TRIAC, SCR, MOSFET, and many other devices. Many technicians have to rely on sources such as datasheets to find the right pin connections and perfect the connection in the circuit. Transistor pinout or terminal identification is very important. Because if you don't connect a transistor correctly in the circuit will not work. And there is a chance you may damage the transistor. We don't want to damage our transistors, they are expensive in some cases. So let's try to talk in detail about how we can identify transistor legs or terminals using the datasheet and digital multimeter methods. I hope you will enjoy this video and in the end, you should be able to correctly identify the right pin configuration of your transistor. There are two main types when we consider the transistor types. 1. NPN transistors. Two N-type semiconductor layers are separated by one P-type layer. 2. PNP transistors. Two P-type semiconductor layers are separated by one N-type layer. Transistor symbol varies along with the point of the arrow. If the arrow points towards the emitter, then it is an NPN transistor, and if the arrow pointing towards the base, it's a PNP transistor. In the NPN transistors, the direction of the current is from collector to the emitter, while in the PNP transistors, the direction of the current is from emitter to collector. NPN transistors turns on when electrons enter into the base terminal, while the PNP transistors turn on when holes enter into the base terminal. In NPN transistors, the majority charge carriers are electrons, and in PNP transistors, the majority charge carriers are holes. NPN transistors are the most widely used transistor types in the industry. Identifying the transistor pinout using the datasheet method. You know, I use this method in my student life a lot. I call this method a student broke method because I didn't have enough money to buy a decent transistor tester for my personal use. Follow these steps in order to identify the transistor pinout using the datasheet method. 1. Take your transistor and read the number printed on the transistor. 2. Google its number in the internet. You can find the transistor number on its body, for example, BC547. 3. Download the datasheet of the transistor. 4. In the datasheet, go the physical structure portion. 5. Place your transistor exactly as shown in the datasheet. 6. Compare the legs. Just put your transistor on your laptop screen in the exact way as shown in the datasheet. 7. There you have it. It is that simple. 8. Mark the terminals as the base, collector, and emitter. The key to success in this method is, please put your transistor exactly as shown in the datasheet. For example, in the datasheet diagram, if the transistor is facing toward you, then you must position your transistor in the same way, that is, facing toward you. The other challenge you might face is that sometimes it will be hard to find the datasheet. But trust me, you will definitely find it. Sometimes, Google has disappointed me, so I used Bing, Yahoo search engines instead, and found the datasheet there. There are a lot of very useful websites there to help you. For example, www.alldatasheet.com, www.datasheetarchive.com. Identification of the three pins of a NPN transistor using multimeter. 1. Set the multimeter to the diode mode. 2. Then keep the positive, red, probe of the multimeter to the middle pin of the transistor. 3. And next, keep the negative, black, probe on the left pin and take the reading from the multimeter. 4. Then take the multimeter reading by keeping the black probe on the right pin of the transistor. 5. When comparing the two readings, the PN junction where the higher reading obtained is the base emitter junction. and the PN junction where lower value obtained is the collector base junction. Identification of the three pins of a PNP transistor using multimeter. 1. Set the multimeter to the diode mode. 2. Then keep the positive, red, probe of the multimeter to the left pin of the transistor. 3. And next, keep the negative, black, probe on the middle pin and take the reading from the multimeter. 4. Then take the multimeter reading by keeping the positive, red, probe on the right pin of the transistor. When comparing the two readings, the PN junction where the higher reading obtained is the base emitter junction, and the PN junction where lower value obtained is the collector base junction.